This photograph was taken by your own NASA Apollo 13 guys on their trip to the moon that didn't work out too well. And many of you may have heard rumors about the story that Apollo 13 had a small nuclear device aboard. And they had been told by the guys that ran NASA that they were going to land on the surface, going to place this small nuclear device. And then when they all left and came back aboard and came back, they were going to detonate it and study the reverberations of this nuclear device, study the seismology of the moon, because they've been convinced for some years that the moon is basically hollow. It appears to be somewhat of an artificial satellite. Well, they planned to develop it to detonate this nuclear device, and then the others said, no, no, you're not going to do that. Get back to that picture again, please. Sorry. I wanted to show you. This picture was taken by Apollo 13. The object you see there in the middle is 5 miles long. It's an artificial, I assume, metallic object, probably crammed with guys. And that object followed our Apollo 13 all the way to the moon, around and back. Now, whether they were trying to make sure the Apollo 13 guys got home safely or what, whether they were the ones responsible for Apollo 13's little accident, which kept them from landing on the moon and placing that nuclear device, who knows? We may find out someday. But here we have an artificial object in orbit on the way to the moon, 5 miles long. Now, I've spent some time aboard aircraft carriers with my kid. I've been invited several times. My boy served on 4 different carriers, nuclear powered Nimitz class carriers. We have carriers with 5,000 men in the crew, 1,000 feet long, 150 aircraft, snack bars, dining rooms, accommodations, this and that. Can you imagine the accommodations on an object? I like to think, you know, McDonald's, bowling alleys, God knows what. I'm sure they have a fairly good life out there. Anyhow, aboard an object 5 miles long, I've tried in the time I had to do two things. To impress upon you the reality of the extraterrestrial presence, the ones I refer to as the others. I hate the term alien, I hate the term UFO. There are no UFOs. We've known what they are for
the others, us and
some
them.
Some of them are ours, some of them are theirs. There are no unidentified flying objects out there. They're all identified. I've tried to impress upon you the seriousness of it, the seriousness of the cover up of the lies they've been telling you. The importance of why you need to know.
Apollo 13 said, NASA, there is a Santa Claus.
Because then you all deserve the truth. You have a right to.
I think it was Houston, there is a Santa Claus.
Because
Santa Claus, code word for E.T.